Hello, it's Erin. I'm back. Hey guys, so today's video is going to be something very different from this channel, as I usually say in the introduction of these videos, because it's not like a usual video that a booktuber would do. I'm coming to you from this video as a fangirl and also as a booktuber as well, but mainly being a fangirl because I'm going to talk about one of my favorite series of all time that I need to speak about. I've spoke about a lot on this channel, but not in depth like I've been talking about. Like, I'll mention it here and there. I mentioned it in my How I Became a Reader video, but I'm going to go more in depth in this series because it's very dear to my heart, and it's because the movies came to a close about a year ago. The series is over. It's done. It's been done for a while, and I want to pay homage to it and just reach out to you other fans of this series out there because this means a lot to me, and it probably means a lot to you too, and I want to do a video where it highlights the series and how much it means to me as a writer and a reader as well. And this is a tribute to the Divergent series by Veronica Roth. This video is going to consist of the memories of how I started reading it, when I started reading it. You know the story already, but I'm going to go over it again just with more detail, because in the last video, if you guys didn't understand how I got into the series, if I didn't explain it well enough, I'll do it again. I'm gonna just give you more detail about that story because I didn't give enough story detail in the last video or a few videos before that when how I became a reader, because I want to highlight how I became a reader but also my reading journey. But this one is gonna highlight specifically the Divergent series and the movies as well. So this video is gonna be very heartfelt. It's gonna be very emotional. It's gonna have a lot of content that is important to me. I did a lot of filming for this video and put a lot of thought into it because the Divergent series means a lot to me, and it's something a video I've been wanting to do for the longest time, and I've been planning on filming it, and I was going to film it last month, but I got backed up with videos, but I'm filming it now because what a better time to film it. A year ago this month, Allegiant came out in theaters, and the series ended a few years ago when Allegiant came out, and then the Allegiant Collector's Edition came out, so I figured, why not now celebrate the series? Not as a sad memory because it ended, but the memories that we have shared with the movie and how Triss inspired us, me as a fangirl, and this is a video for the fans. Without further ado, enjoy. If you guys are new subscribers to my channel, you probably do not know that I talk about the Divergent series a lot on this channel. It's one of my favorite series that I have ever read in my life. I am so wrapped up in this fandom. It means a lot to me. Most of my friends on Twitter I met because of this fandom. My social media, my Instagram, my Twitter, because of the series, because it inspired me so much. My channel was mainly inspired by other booktubers, but it is angled towards being a fangirl as well, and being a booktuber and a writer, but my social media is mainly surrounded around the Divergent series and why I made it in the first place, and I'll get to that story later. If you're new subscribers, I'm just going to talk to you guys for a second. If you guys don't know what the Divergent series is about, I highly suggest you read it. It surrounds a girl, the first book, Divergent. It's a trilogy. There's three books in the series, and the four is in another character's POV, but that's not important. I'm going to tell you what it's about, and then I'm going to give you some facts about the series, because I thought I would include all of you new subscribers who don't know what the Divergent series is, if you've never seen the movies. And if you've seen the movies, I'm going to tell you they're very, very different from the books. So I suggest you read the books and then watch the movies because they're very, very different. The first movie matches pretty well. The other two, not so much, but they were very good movies as well. And I enjoyed going to the movie theater and enjoying them as well. But I'll get to that later on. To my new subscribers, I'm going to explain the Divergent series. Divergent is surrounded a girl named Triss Pryor. She's different from everybody else. She's our main protagonist. She lives in Chicago. It's a dystopian. The world is divided into factions. We got Abnegation, the Selfless, Candor, the Honest, Dauntless, the Brave, Amity, the Peaceful, and we got Erudite, the Smart Ones. And they all value those specific qualities. And Triss is from Abnegation born, and she transfers to Dauntless. They go through these series of simulations. It's a new technology. It's dystopian, so it's like futuristic. And she finds out that she's not like everybody else. She's divergent, which basically means that she realizes she's in a simulation and she can get herself out of it if she wants to. Well, she does most of the time. And it also follows her love interest named Four, where she meets him and he helps her through this because he is divergent as well. So we go through his journey and hers as well, but it's in her POV. Whereas in the last book, it's in Triss and Four's POV. I'm not going to tell you much more about the series because I don't want to spoil you guys on the series and what happens, but most of you probably know what happens at the end because most of my subscribers, you guys, probably read the series already, but new subscribers, if you haven't, please read the series. It means a lot and it will give you such joy. It's fantastic writing. The author, Veronica Roth, is an inspiration to me. She's a big impact on my life. She's the reason why I'm going to school for creative writing and I'm writing my own novel in the first place and why all this stuff is happening. If it wasn't for the series, I probably wouldn't know what I'd be doing with my life. I'd probably want to go into journalism because that's what I wanted to do originally, or have no idea. But this series has a very big impact on my life, thus I'm making a tribute to it. Now, the other book, Four, is written in Four's POV, and it's because, fun fact, I'm going to give you some facts now, which leads me to the next part of this spiel I'm going to give you guys. Divergent originally was written in Four's POV, and Veronica Roth was writing it, and she figured she wanted to write in Triss's POV instead of Four's. Thus, the novella happened. Well, she decided to write a novella in Four's POV and find out his side of the story and why Allegiant is in both POVs, both Triss and Four. I'm not going to lie, most BookTubers don't like the fact that it's in two POVs. And I'm an okay fan of it. I don't really prefer it, but it's okay for me. But it just at times I got confused reading her POV and his POV. But at times I did enjoy it because we saw through his eyes and I liked it a lot. I was reading the novella and Allegiant at the same time, which worked out pretty well because it flowed very well and the timing with reading both these things at the same time worked very well. And I'm glad I timed that very well. I don't want to confuse you guys. And the three books are Divergent, Insurgent, Allegiant, and Four, but don't read Four yet. Just read Divergent first. But Divergent is written in Triss's POV. Just read the first book first. If you like it, continue on to the series. Go read it. You'll enjoy it. I've recommended it to a lot of people and they want to read it and I'm glad that I did. I've recommended it to all of you guys in some of my Divergent videos that I have filmed for you guys. You guys know, subscribers, on old subscribers, I'm going to reach out to you guys. You guys know that I talk about the series quite a lot on this channel. I filmed trailer talks for the movies that were released, starting with Insurgent, because when Divergent was made, I had not had this channel up yet. And you can check out those videos on this channel and under this playlist or whatever playlist I put it under. But I suggest you read the books. If you want, you can watch the movies. Doesn't matter. I'm not going to tell you not to watch the movies. I'm just going to tell you the movies don't match quite as well to the books as the books do. At least the last two movies do not. The first one matches pretty well to the movie because they got a good director and the director knew what he was doing and he filmed the movie very, very well and they did a very good job. The last two movies weren't geared toward the book as well because they got a new director and he did things his own way. But I prefer you guys watch Divergent first, and if you want to move on after, that's fine. I know a lot of BookTubers are very angry about what happened after Insurgent and Allegiant. A lot of BookTubers do not like the last movies and they bash them. Let me be honest with you guys. I am a fangirl. I'm a BookTuber as well. I am not going to bash the series, no matter how bad it is. If other BookTubers wanna, that's their opinion. I'm not gonna judge them on that. I just feel that the series was important to me and I wanted to watch the movies regardless if they matched or not. Did they match? No. Are they good? Yes, as a film itself, yes, but not an adaptation. They matched, but very, very, very little. Like, goes in the order of the books, but they just added little stuff in between, which I really didn't care for too much. But I still enjoyed every movie. The great casting, the movies were fantastic. The movies star Shailene Woodley, Theo James, Ansel Elgort, Miles Teller. You probably know all these people from the movies, and it was a beautiful, beautiful movie. The first movie was phenomenal. Shailene Woodley and Theo James were fantastic, and the rest of the cast was fantastic as well. The elements were very, very good, and you got so many cast members in it, as well as Kate Winslet and Zoe Kravitz, and so many very, very talented people were in the series. I loved it so much. You got Naomi Watts, that was in the second one, and then the one after that, and it was so good. And the books were good, but again, I prefer you watch Divergent, because that one matches the most out of all of them. But if you want, go ahead, watch the rest of the movies, but I'm just going to warn you now, they don't match. I don't judge the trailer, I just go see the movie, because I was talking to my friend about this on Twitter not too long ago. This person's like, well, you're not like other booktubers. You're not like gonna judge it based on the adaptation. You're gonna base it on a movie. And that's the way I see things. If these booktubers, they're very hardcore, they wanna judge an adaptation because it doesn't match. That's not me. I will like the movie regardless if it matches or not. I don't care if it doesn't match, but I'm getting off topic here. My point is, watch the first movie, and if you want, watch the rest. I'm not gonna tell you what to do. I'm a very free-flowing person. I've watched all movies personally, I love them. I've watched A Legion half a dozen times when it's on HBO because it's a really good vibe for me. I watch it when I write, I watch it when I edit videos, and it helps me. I like watching the movies because I'm also a film lover, so I like to watch it a lot of times because I like to watch the angles and see things that I haven't seen before, maybe in the movie theater that I didn't catch. I like watching it again, experiencing the nostalgia that is Divergent. I haven't seen the first movie in a while, but I will probably watch it again soon. And it just brings back so many memories. I love watching the first one. It's my favorite one out of all of them. Seeing the movie for the first time, which I will get to the story on that too. I have a lot of stories for you guys, so keep in mind of that. But anyway, new subscribers, read the series. Optional, watch the movies. Doesn't matter, but most of you probably seen the movies and maybe didn't read the books. Go ahead. If you've seen the movies and you want to read the books, go ahead. Don't let the movies, if you've seen the movies ahead of time, stop you from reading the books because you think that's what happened in the books, especially what happened in Legion with all that futuristic stuff. Don't let it stop you. The books are way better than the movies. They're always going to be. No matter how well the adaptation is for any movie, no matter how well the adaptation is, no matter how well they match the book to the film or whatever, the book is always going to be better than the film. Always, always, 100%. So don't let the movies or any adaptation stop you from actually reading the book. Like if you've seen like The Fault in Our Stars, that was a very good film and it matched the book very well. But just because you've seen the end and got spoiled, don't let that stop you from reading the book, because the book will give you more detail that the movie didn't. Because the movie's not always going to have the detail that the book has, and you'll notice that. I've noticed that when I saw 50 Shades Darker, and I noticed that when I saw Allegiant, Divergent, The Hunger Games. Everything is going to be different when you see the films. With any adaptation, it doesn't matter. Even TV shows that are based off films. It's always going to be different. The books are just 100% better, especially in this case. But please read the books, even if you've seen the movies and you were spoiled. And especially if you heard things about the end of Allegiant, because they're ending that everybody talks about on the internet like all the time. Read the books. I suggest you do, because you won't regret it. Even if you got spoiled. I got spoiled during the last book, and I read it anyway because I had read the series. I mean, I waited too long to read Allegiant, but I read it anyway. And guys, I know I keep saying it, but please, please read the series. It's very good. That's all I'm going to say on that to my new subscribers, and I'm going to get to the real point of this video. So, now, everyone, old subscribers, you can come back and watch this. Don't want me ramble to new subscribers, convince them to read the series. I think I did a pretty good job of convincing them. I'm gonna give you guys a couple of stories about how the series inspires me, but then how it's inspirational as well. So, the first part of this video is gonna consist of stories of how I started reading the series, and then we're gonna go on to the movie part and how I got my merch and everything. It's gonna be very chatty, so sit back, relax. It's gonna be a while, but it's gonna be a very good video for you fans, and you guys are gonna love this because it's gonna bring so much nostalgia. It's bringing so much nostalgia back for me because I'm putting on all this black. I'm dressing like Triss. It brings it back from when I used to dress up for the movies. So, let's get started with the first part of this video. So, my cousin is the person, as previously stated in How I Became a Reader video. If you haven't seen that video, go check it out. My cousin told me to read it because I just finished reading The Hunger Games. I was reading Twilight. And my cousin just kept bugging me. She's like, read the series, read the series, read the series. I looked it up on Wikipedia. I looked up the synopsis, looked kind of confusing online, but I read it anyway because my cousin had told me it was the synopsis for the book was kind of confusing, but I read the synopsis. And then I had started reading the book and I told my cousin, I said, the synopsis online is so confusing. And she's like, it is confusing, but the book makes more sense. And it does. It may look confusing to the other people, but once you start reading the books, it makes sense. And if you really concentrate and you really think about it, it's a very easy series. I blew through it really quick. Very, very short chapters as well, so that's why I blew through it so quick. I didn't read it when it first came out. When it first got published, I believe in 2011, the first book. And I did not read it until 2014 because my cousin's like, well, the movie's coming out, so maybe you should read the book because it's very good. She was told, I think via social media, to convince somebody to read the book. And I was one of those people, and she convinced me to read it, and I'm very glad she did. At first, she told me not to read it because it's kind of confusing, but then she's like, just read it. It's very good. So she changed her mind. She told me to read it. So I did. So my cousin's another reason why I am doing what I'm doing today. And my love for the series. My cousin loves the series just as much as I do. She's not a big fan of the movies, but she loves the books. And she's a fangirl as well, but I'm a bigger fangirl than she is. But you get my point. I'm gonna give you some stories about how I read the series, and it will lead into my stories about seeing the movie for the first time and being a total fangirl, and I'm gonna fangirl about it. So my cousin had told me to read the series. I had read it. I was so captivated by the writing, and from the moment I read the book, I saw the trailers for the movies, I was fangirling about the trailers, I was so excited, I had seen this phenomenal cast, and I was like so excited about the movies, I saw the trailers, I was fangirling about it, I was so excited, I could not wait for the movie, I was very, very excited, and I could not wait for the movies. And there was a phenomenal cast and everything. Which leads into my story about when I saw the movie. When Divergent came out in 2014, I had just finished, I think I was finished reading the second book or the third book. I don't know what book I was on when the movie came out. And I was full blown. I was so submerged into the fandom. I made my social media. I was so excited. And Divergent again is another reason why I made my social media. So it was very exciting. When I got submerged into the fandom and I saw all these trailers, that's when I got excited. I went to Hot Topic, I got all the merch, I got all the magazines that had come out about the movie, everything that was about the fandom. Whenever they had like the Entertainment Weekly, Illustrated Guide to the Movie, Us Weekly, the People Magazine, I have a bunch of posters up in my room right here. You can't see them, but I'll show you them maybe in a future video. I have a picture of Four, aka Theo James, up, and I have a big Divergent poster that I had gotten like a couple years ago for Christmas. My cousin had gotten me, but I have that up on my bed because the Divergent films still make me happy to this day, and I know Four and Tris are protecting me while I sleep, which is a weird thing, but it's true. I have the posters from the Us Weekly on my door outside. I'm a major fan of, there's Hunger Games stuff up on my walls as well, and Mortal Instruments and all that other stuff, but so anyway, I got all the magazines, I got the merch, I went to Hot Topic, it's when we all had that merch, we were so excited, we just darted out to that store and we got it. I got the Four blanket, I got the Tris tattoos, I got the t-shirt, I was all ready for the film, I saw the films, I dressed up for them, I cosplayed each day as every faction for school, and people didn't understand what I was dressed as, but it was still fun anyway. I took pictures on Instagram, posted them. I went to see the movies, I wore my t-shirt, I took a picture next to the poster. If you guys are new subscribers or if you guys are following me on social media, you can go into my old post and I gave a review of the films from like back in the day, and it was just such a fun experience to be part of the fandom and talking to all of you on Twitter and Instagram. If you've seen my conversations with a couple of my friends in the fandom, I have one of my best friends that I met in the fandom and we talk all the time. And it's just so fun going back and talking about it. And we talk about how we cry when we hear the music or the soundtrack. I got most of the songs from the soundtrack. And even today when I listen to the music, it just makes me feel emotional and nostalgic at the same time. And it just brings so much feelings back from when back in the day when I saw that movie. I saw it the first day it came out. There was a big poster outside of Hot Topic. I took a picture next to it. And I was so submerged into this fandom. I'm so glad I entered it. It was such a good experience for me. I read Divergent in the summer and that's how my book happened, and I'm just so honored that I'm part of this fandom and I've seen all the movies and I am so happy I did, and I can't ask for much more than that. We were supposed to get one more movie. First it was gonna be Allegiant Part 2 because the first one was supposed to be Allegiant Part 1 and it was supposed to be Allegiant Part 2. And then they changed it back to Ascendant, and we were supposed to get the last film. But that didn't happen. We were waiting on news for filming, and because everybody knew, I was new to the Divergent fandom when the first movie was filming, so I didn't know much about it, but I was informed about when Insurgent was filming because I was on Instagram at the time, and that's how I made my social media. But that's not the point. So we were waiting for news about filming and everything because the directors, they were tweeting and everything. It all started when the director of Allegiant backed out and we got a new director for Ascendant. We were all ready. We got a date. We were supposed to premiere this last Friday of this year, I think, or sometime this month it was supposed to premiere. But then that got pushed back because they were going to premiere a new movie called Power Rangers. Power Rangers took its slot. Ascendant was supposed to be released in June. And we were okay with that. The cast was set to come back. We were ready for a movie. I think they were looking for sets and everything. And they were all set to go back to Atlanta where they filmed the last two movies. The first one was filmed in Chicago. And we got all this news and we were all waiting. And we talked to the director online. And he was saying things about how he was excited to join the project and everything. And Lionsgate released More Information, which is the company that produced the films. Lionsgate produced the films, but it's a Summit production, which is Summit is a sister company of Lionsgate. So Lionsgate bought Summit, and Summit is made Twilight, and they made Divergent. The Hunger Games was made by Lionsgate, but Summit is its sister company. So they're the same company under the umbrella that is Lionsgate. So enough about the production company. It was kind of quiet. We didn't know what was going on. And then we hear that it's possibly going to happen, but we're not. The cast doesn't know. Shailene said the same when she was doing press for Snowden. She said, they asked her what's going to happen with Ascendant. And they said she's hoping that they were going to come back for a next movie. But she didn't know what was going on. None of the cast did. They had no idea what was happening. We knew that we had a director, but we didn't know anything much more than that. And after a lot of, like, everything going on, there was rumors going around that it was gonna do this and that and go in this direction. There were a lot of rumors, a lot of uncertainty. Lionsgate wasn't releasing any statements based on the movie, and we were so curious. Recently, I'd say about a few months ago, maybe 6 months, I don't remember, but pretty recently, it was announced that Ascendant was going to become a TV movie and going to derive from a TV show. At first, Variety had released this news, and we had known if Variety was true or not, and we were looking it up. And apparently it is true. Like, everybody was saying it all over the web. What I'm hearing now is it's becoming a TV movie. It's not becoming a movie. It's not going to be in theaters. The original cast is not going to be in it. It's going to be a new cast. It's going to be a TV show. It's going to lead into a TV show like Shadowhunters, and it's going to be a completely new thing. They're going to start from the beginning. They're going to start from scratch. And honestly, when that news came out, the fandom was very upset. We weren't going to see Shay. We weren't going to see Theo anymore. We were going to see Miles. We were going to see Ansel. We were going to see Zoe. So we were very upset. The cast was not signed up to do a TV movie, but to do a film in the theaters, not that. And after all these rumors and everybody was like in denial, we were all like, this can't be happening. And then it started to settle in that it's not gonna happen. And originally, I think Starz had bought the movie or something for the TV show. I'm not positive what company had bought it. I don't really know the details of it. I just heard what I heard online and what I've been talking to my friends about, and these statements have been released. Recently that came out, finally Lionsgate released a statement, and they came out lining and they told us what they were going to do, because they wanted the fans to know as well what was going to go on with the series, because the series is our baby, we love it, and we want it to continue. Now's the story behind the fans. We are not going to watch the TV show or the movie, because it's not the same as the film. We're not going to have the cast. We bonded with the cast, watching the movies, watching the interviews. The cast went to Comic-Con in 2014 when the movie was going to premiere. They went the previous year for Insurgent. We saw all the premiere pictures from Allegiant, Divergent, Insurgent. We bonded with this cast. So I don't like the idea of seeing a new cast on this film or a movie or whatever they're going to do with it. I don't like the idea of it because I bonded so well with this cast working at it. And the fandom, the fans are the same way. They were upset, were outraged, but there's nothing we can do about it. But film in the theater is not gonna happen. We're all hoping that there's gonna be some miracle and it'll happen, but honestly, I don't think it's gonna happen, because if a statement's been released, it's not gonna happen. But again, everything's still up in the air, so we don't know. Veronica Roth didn't know at the time, and none of us did. So, thus, we are going to just reflect on the last three movies rather than just what's gonna lie ahead and all the nostalgia surrounding the movies and everything, mainly surrounding this whole series and as well as the books. This video is gonna be about the books as well, not just the movies. Divergent is another reason why I made my social media, as stated before. I made my Instagram first. My original Instagram name was DivergentFan93. I changed it to personal because the fandom, which is another reason why I have to explain to you my social media change. I changed it about a week ago. And the reason why I changed it was because, not that I'm not in the fandom anymore. I am. I'm in it 100%. I think about the series every day. I'm going to reread it. I watched the movies like 500,000 times. So I'm still in the fandom. My account's more personal now because the fandom has died down. A lot of people just started posting multi-fandom stuff. I am strictly a personal account. It's a new name. It's a clever name I made up for writing. And I just figured that it's the Divergent fandom is kind of starting to simmer to a little bit, but we're still gonna be here. We're not gonna like drift apart and be like, oh, okay, like we're gonna like drift apart and not talk to each other again. We still talk about Divergent today, but not as much as we used to. And we do a lot of Twitter chats and everything, so we're always there. I still post about Divergent, but not as much as I used to. I'm not as much part of fandoms on Instagram or Twitter. I'm more like gonna post more about videos and when I film and my writing and everything else. But I'm still gonna be posting about fandoms and like birthdays of like people on the cast or something like that. I'm still gonna post about that stuff, but not like as much as I used to. Not less fandom and more writing, but still fandoms there. If I explained that well enough in this part of the video. But I did at one point, it was for at least 3 years, it was fandom based, but now it's becoming strictly personal. And my Twitter was more like personal when I made it in the first place. That really didn't change much, but I do follow a lot of fandoms on Twitter too, so it's fandom based. And most of the fandoms I follow on Instagram are fandoms as well, and I have a good time because I get updates on the cast and what they're up to, even after the movies, and I'm very happy I get that chance. Enough about my social media, I'm going to do a video about that later on in the next few months. So, I'm going to talk about my inspiration. Now, not only does Veronica Roth inspire me as a writer, but her character Triss, Beatrice Pryor, she is the one that inspires me to go beyond the limits and to be brave and to be selfless and to be kind and everything. And she's such a great heroine to follow. She's a big inspiration in all of our lives. She inspired most of the fandom and everybody. She's a great role model to look up to, and she may be fictional, but I hope that one day when my book is published, that my readers will look up to my character, my protagonist, as they look up to Triss. Triss inspires me to be brave and to go beyond limits, and her perseverance makes me jump to new strengths, and I became more confident because of her. Create a great character just as great as Veronica Roth did. She did an amazing job by creating Divergent. She is so talented, and like I said, if I hadn't read her books, I probably wouldn't be writing my book, going into creative writing, or loving writing just in general. Nicholas Barth did inspire me to write, as I had said before, but Veronica Roth is the reason why I'm writing and why I became a writer and why I'm going into creative writing at school and everything that happened surrounding my book. And I probably wouldn't know what I would be doing today if it weren't for her and her captivating words Veronica, if you are listening, you inspire me so much to become a writer and to become a reader. And if it weren't for your books and your words, that I wouldn't have been doing what I'm doing today. You have a major, major impact on my life. You are so inspirational to me. You made me realize that I want to go into creative writing other than journalism, and how I want to write creatively and become a creative writer and loving it so much and creating my own book and my own protagonist and my own characters. You sparked that switch that made my ideas explode and made me want to write creatively and made all these ideas just start coming and putting them to a page and start writing and start deriving from an idea, from a word, from a character, from a book, to a book, to a story that is now become my novel. It may have went through numerous drafts, but you are the reason why I started writing my book in the first place. Divergent is a phenomenal series. I hope that I get to tell you all this in person, because I would love to tell you how much you had an impact on my career and how much your writing is phenomenal and why I'm doing what I'm doing today and how inspirational you are to me. And I hope I get to meet you and I get to tell you about my book. And I'd love to talk to you about writing and how my book happened and the whole story about it and how Divergent really did inspire my book. How Divergent did really inspire me to become a writer, and how you inspired me to become a writer because of your words. And I just cannot stress it enough. Your words are amazing, and you really, really, really did have a big impact on my life and my career choice and everything that happened in my life and why I love writing, why I became a writer, and how I fell in love with writing and how I know how good I am at it. And I don't know how it happened, but I just have so many ideas. I've been told my writing is good and I have all these ideas, and you sparked something that made me want to become a writer, and I cannot thank you so much for that. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much for being an inspiration to me and making me want to become a writer and making me fall in love with writing and everything surrounding it. So thank you. Thank you very much, Veronica. Thank you. This series is the reason I'm writing my own novel, because of the words that captivated me from the first page. Honestly, I don't know what I would be doing now if it weren't for Veronica Roth and the series. Both she and the book she created had a major impact on my life and my career choice to become a published author. And I hope to become just as successful as her one day. And for you guys, I want to thank you guys. Right now, I'm becoming fans and becoming my friends. The movies and the book series may be over, but I will always remember Triss and Four and the way they taught me to be brave and the impact they had on my life. I love following the journeys they took in all the books, but I will always have this series to look back on, not as a fan, but as a reader as well. Nearing the end of this video, I want to say thank you for becoming my friends and meeting you guys on social media and talking about the series. And thank you to everyone that I met. And thank you to the Divergent fandom for introducing me to this fandom and immersing me into something passionate about something I love, and how much I love this series and how much the memories it brought me from seeing the movies to reading the books to becoming a fangirl to just everything all out. Thank you, Veronica Roth, for inspiring me to write my own book and to become an author and to go into creative writing. Thank you for inspiring me and being a big impact on my life. That is my career. I owe you a big debt of gratitude, and I just want to say thank you. Thank you, thank you so much for inspiring me. And thank you to the fans. Thank you to everybody in the fans. So thank you, Divergent. Thank you, the Divergent series. That is my video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. This was just a little nostalgic video that I decided to bring to this channel. Something a little different and something I thought you guys would enjoy, because you know how much I love the Divergent series and how much you guys thought this was a great idea. And I'm glad I made the video, and I'm glad I connected with you guys on Twitter to help me with this. I'm very glad I reached out to you guys. I had a very good time filming all these action shots I had filmed, all the book angles and all the angles I filmed for you guys. I had a great time creating it. I felt like Triss, and I felt compelled to make the video because your series is important to me as a writer, as I've said before, and I'm so glad that I made this video, and I'm just glad that I'm in this fandom, and I will be for a very, very long time. And again, I just want to say thank you to everyone who helped, and to the fandom, to Veronica, everyone. Now, with that being said, if you guys don't know my social media, a little side announcement that's not related to this video. I did change my social media. It is, as said before, is now personal on Instagram, but I still post fandom stuff, and Twitter. But on Instagram, it's going to be mainly video updates and writing updates, and mainly when I'm filming and when I'm writing and stuff surrounding that, when I buy books, and it's going to be like a book writing, filming kind of account where I changed my username. It is not DivergentFan93 anymore. Now I am rail writing on both Twitter and Instagram. So if you guys don't get confused, they're the same name now, so you guys can follow both accounts and I will be there. You guys will know that. And Snapchat is the same, it's DivergentFan93. I've yet to change my username on that, but for the time being, it is DivergentFan93. I'll probably change my username in the future, but for the time being, it is DivergentFan93. If it changes, I will post something about it on social media to let you guys know that it changed, or I will let you know in a video or at the end of my video, because I'm at the end of my writing video. I changed my social media after I made the video, so that's why I didn't say it, and I didn't realize it till the end when I was gonna upload it. So that's why I made that little announcement at the end of the video. I wrote something in. But my social media did change, and it is now rail writing on Twitter and Instagram. I just wanted to get that out there. So yes, I did change my social media, but it's going to be the same stuff that I've been posting, basically, but morely personal-based. And don't forget to follow, like, subscribe, and I will see you guys soon. Goodbye!